Sometimes before you write an article, I sit down and I ask myself whether or not it could be tempting fate in any way. I ask myself whether the article could be seen as boastful or cocky, too confident or arrogant to be considered a decent attempt at a thought-provoking piece. I went through the standard reflections before this piece and could only come to the conclusion that what I wanted to write, while definitely running the risk of going over the top, was worth the time and effort, and it would act as a genuine reflection on my thoughts and feelings. As we sit on the verge of another Ashes series, nothing in world sport brings out the passion and emotion like an Ashes series. Australia and England, two old foes permanently linked by history and plenty of shared mannerisms, going toe-to-toe across FIFA test matches, 25 days of cricket, hundreds of deliveries and plenty of runs. It's the perfect addition to that most perfect of Australian summer, a unique charm. Ashes series in England have their own charm for those of you as lucky enough to live in the southern land, with the late night spent with the television volume low, the words of boycott or Atherton or whoever barely audible, the twang of Henry Blofeld trying but not quite successy hiding the posh disdain many English toffs have for you as Aussies. Those late nights provide some of my fondest memories, but they pale in comparison to a scorching afternoon spent absorbing as much cricket as heat as the men under their baggy green caps torment the English, who look sunburnt and over the whole idea. Yes, the English have had their successes in Australia over the years, but overall, as with most other series against opponents from all around the world on home soil, Australia stands tallest this summer. We have the opportunity to bear witness to another mark in the long and storied history of the great rivalry. The English come down under with the urn in their carry-on luggage, Joe Root undoubtedly brandishing the small treasure at each opportunity. They are talking the right talk, they know they're the underdogs as always, and they're prepared to cop whatever the Aussies dish out at them, verbally as much as with bat or ball, and fight back on the strength of their cricket. The English side boasts some wonderful talent. Root himself is a splendid wielder of the willow, while Jimmy Anderson and Stuart Broad have had some fine moments against Australia in their long and glittering careers, but from where is it, bias hope is somewhat in check. The Australian side look hungry, they hungry and they appear ready to attack the English from the offset. The Aussies look ready, soaring pace from Mitchell Starc and Pat Cummins, the former almost unplayable at his best, the latter blossoming as the fast bowling behemoth we always knew how he could be. Josh Hazlewood's rhythmic line and length oft compared to the great Glenn McGrath, ready to grind the English batsman down. Nathan Lyon, affectionately termed the GOAT greatest of all time, is the greatest off spinner in Australian history for a reason, and his bounce and turn look a formidable challenge for a thin-looking English middle order. With the bat, Steve Smith could just be the best since Bradman, has growing as a skipper, learning the great art of leading a test side, but with willow in hand and simply the challenge of a bowler in front of him. Few look more accomplished in world cricket. David Warner, the wild card, so often an unknown quantity, looks ready to cash in. With big runs alongside the stoic and well-tempered Matt Renshaw, while Usman Khawaja appears understanding of the need for runs on home soil to boost his stocks with selectors, Matuidi appears on the outer, and as the hallelujahs sing out, Peter Neville should earn a reprieve, which would see a more competent gloveman behind the stumps, and Australia lose nothing with the bat. The tourists look pedestrian for the English, even their own fans have a little confidence in Gary Balance. The 27-year-old Yorkshire star has had a patchy run at test level, averaging a tick over 37 with the bat, and he looks one that could genuinely struggle with the bounce and extra pace he'll see, especially in Brisbane and Perth, where many a better English run scorer has fallen victim to a fiery Australian pace attack. The less said about the whole base talks, the better. The all-rounder, in my books, should not be allowed to tour based on his gross misconduct and brass attack outside an English nightclub. Whatever the reason, his conduct was completing on becoming of a professional athlete and role model, and simply put, there's no place in our game for his thuggery. Of the other, David Malan doesn't appear to pose much threat, averaging 23.62 in his 5 tests to date and just 37.24 in his first class career. James Finch hasn't exceeded 42 runs in an innings during his 7 test matches and averages less than 20 with the bat, while a 30-year-old lefty Mark Stoneman has been drafted in on the back of an average of just 30 in 3 tests and an average of 35.28 at first class level. Simply put, there's no real fear factor about this English side. The bulk of the squad is made up of half-decent domestic cricketers who have really bargained the door down with piles of runs or a mountain of wickets, while their man strike weapons with the ball, Stuart Broad and James Anderson, are 31 and 35 respectively, and while they have been champion players most of their careers, both could genuinely struggle with long spells in hot conditions that are likely not going to favor their penchant for swing. I am not going to sit here and suggest England have no chance, because they certainly do. The Ashes are an endurance test, they force players players to dig deep and there will be moments where momentum swings their way. The difference I feel is the overall quality between the two seeders Australia in comparison to their old foe. Look well prepared and well drilled and should win out on the strength of their talent and commitment alone. As Glenn McGrath would say, 50 Australia, bring on a huge summer. Who do you think will win the Ashes series this summer? Let us know in the poll and comments below. Want to share your opinion? Why not write for us previous post previous next post next.